A very good morning, my dear students. So today, like before that, we have completed chapter 8, that is redox, and I hope all these things are clear. So now I'm going to start unit 7, that is equilibrium. And it's a very long chapter and it needs more and more attention, as well as your like concentration, complete concentration should be there, then only you will get it. It is divided in two parts. One is chemical equilibrium and another is ionic equilibrium. So first we will do with the we'll start with the chemical equilibrium, and then afterward we will do that ionic equilibrium. So let's start today's video with a quote, and the quote is, if you really want to do something, you will find a way, and if you don't, you will find an excuse. And this is 100% applicable to student life. Like if you want to do, if you want to watch or you want to study, you will find the way wherever like you are busy and all that. But if you don't want, you have lots of excuses around it, and you will find that which will be the better excuse for this. So that is 100% correct. So I hope after knowing this quote, you will try to understand and you will not find the excuse. Rather, you will find the way to do something. Okay. So let's start the topic, and that is the introduction. Equilibrium is the state at which the concentration of reactant and products do not change with time. So whenever like equilibrium ki baat, again, if we will do that equilibrium, first of all, we should know that when this equilibrium will exist. Yes. So equilibrium never occurs in the irreversible process. If the process is irreversible, that means A is going to change into B. And B is not going back, not turning back in A. So that means this reaction is called irreversible process. And this reaction will not show any equilibrium. Okay. But if to show this equilibrium, we ask like that reaction must be first thing. The first most important thing. Let me write here important thing. That reaction should be reversible. This is very much important reaction, important term. Okay, then only you will see that equilibrium in the reaction, otherwise this will not be exist. Okay, so in one way we can say that in any, during any chemical equation, the stage where we cannot see any change in observable properties, whatever the observable properties are there, such as color, concentration, temperature and all that, so there will be no change in that. That is called equilibrium. Another example like you might have seen with this. Suppose that there are two container, okay, and in this two container there is a gap, like there is a connection between this, like this. Yes, connection is, suppose that we can say that this is connected, interconnected. Okay, so in this case, if this water is there, and right now for this the nozzle is closed over here, so this water will be like this tank will be completely filled, and this will be, there will be no water in this. But as we will open this nozzle, what will happen, this water will go on, will move in this beaker also, in this container also, and it will like, it will flow from this beaker to, from first beaker to second beaker, till that this, what we say, that the level of the water in both the beaker, in both the container will be equal. Suppose that this water has gone, okay, so we can say that here, that now it is in equilibrium. So it means that this, there will be no movement from beaker 1 to beaker 2 or beaker 2 to beaker 1 here. That's this is in equilibrium. Got it? So there will be no observable change in this case. Got it? Okay. So we can say that equilibrium is the state at which the concentration of reactant and products do not change with any time. Another example of this, that is equilibrium, you can see that both the side, that here, whatever the weight and this weight are same. So that's why this is like in the straight line. Yes. If agar kahin ka bhi weight zyada hoga, to obviously if this weight will be more, it will go down. Or if this weight will be more, this will go down. Isn't it? So, since both are having same weight, we can say over here. So, that's why this is in the equilibrium. That is not in any like particular direction. Mein wo niche nahi hai. So, here come to the point. Equilibrium AB change into C plus D. Equilibrium, the reaction which is in equilibrium, इसको शो करने के लिए द बेस्ट थिंग दैट वी शो विद दिस रिवर्सिबल डायरेक्शन एरो, दिस इज यस रिवर्सिबल डायरेक्शन. सो दैट इज दैट शोज दैट दिस रिएक्शन इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम. ओके, इन अ रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ द रिएक्शन कैन रिएक्ट टू प्रोड्यूस द ओरिजिनल रिएक्टेंट. दैट मीन्स ए प्लस बी विल कन्वर्ट इन टू सी प्लस डी एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स सी प्लस डी कैन कन्वर्ट इन टू ए प्लस बी टू. Yes, this is also called a dynamic equilibrium. Dynamic equilibrium, that means it will go in forward direction as well as it can move in the backward direction. Okay, so at dynamic equilibrium, the rates of the forward and backward reaction are equal. This is very important point over here. At dynamic equilibrium, the rate of forward reaction will be equal to rate of backward reaction. That is the most important point for the equilibrium. Okay, and in that case, we can say that the change of the reactant and the products do not change. The concentration of reactant and products do not change. Another example is given over here. A removes dirt at the same rate as 2 replaces it. A jitna remove kar raha hai, utna hi 2 wahan se kya kar raha hai, usko replace kar raha hai. Got it? So the size of the hole and the pile of the dirt stay will be same. Jitna wo gaddha kiya hua hai, utna hi udhar jada. Soil will be there. Yes, or dirt will be there. The equilibrium state. So it says that in the proceeding reaction, a final stage is reached when no further change in concentration of reactant and product is observed. That means whatever the reactant formed and the product concentration are there, there will be no further change. It will not move. At this stage, there is a balance between reactant and product, and the reaction appears to have stopped. It feels that it gives the appearance that it is stopped. Now the reaction is not moving in any direction. That stage, that particular stage, is called equilibrium stage. To our eyes, that means at the microscopic level, which we can see, yes, nothing appears to be happening. कुछ भी वहां पे होता हुआ दिखता नहीं है. ये तो ऑन अ मॉलिक्यूलर लेवल देयर इज अ कंटिन्यूअस चेंज. ऐसा नहीं है कि वहां पे वो बिल्कुल एट द इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेज इट विल स्टॉप्ड. नो, इट इज नॉट स्टॉप्ड. मैक्रोस्कोपिक लेवल पे इट विल दैट देयर विल बी नो चेंज इन दैट. बट इफ यू गो इन द मॉलिक्यूलर लेवल देयर विल बी कंटिन्यूअस चेंज विल बी देयर एंड इट इज हैपनिंग ओवर देयर. यस, देयरफॉर दीज आर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय डबल एरोस indicating that product coexists with reactant. That means at there will be a certain time in which that reactant and product both are equal in concentration, and except initial and the final stage, we can see that at any moment of the reaction, this reaction coexists with the reactant, that concentration of product coexists with the reactant also. Got it? For example, the equilibrium for the reaction of nitrogen and hydrogen to form ammonia may be represented as N2 plus 3H2 change into 2NH3. You will better understand this by another example. Let me explain you. It will come in next slide. Okay. So, in this case, if we see that at t is equal to 0 time, suppose that at t is equal to 0 time, okay, that means the reaction has not started. Suppose that this is X over here. And this is Y over here. So, at this time, product is not there. So, it will be 0. Got it? But at any other time, T is equal to T time. It's not equilibrium. I'm not talking about equilibrium. Agar equilibrium aa jayega, then this concentration will be equal to this concentration. Got it? So, some portion will be will decrease from this. Suppose that A is decreased. And this is also A part is decreasing over this in this. So, what is this product formation? What will be the concentration of product here? Jitna ye ghatega, reactant ghat raha hai, the same concentration for product will be formed. Got it? Samajh mai baat? So, this is just for example. You will better understand in next slide where I will explain with the coefficients. Okay? That matter, that also plays a role. Okay? So, let's move to next slide. Equilibrium, that is called dynamic in nature. Why it is called dynamic in nature? That means, let me explain you. At equilibrium, both forward and backward reaction are still taking place. अगर हम फैक्ट की बात करें तो वहां पे इक्विलिब्रियम पे दोनों ही रिएक्शन साथ साथ होते हैं, फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन एंड बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन दोनों ही कर रहे होते हैं, बट द रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन एंड द बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन बिकम्स इक्वल. मतलब जितने रेट से रिएक्टेंट प्रोडक्ट में कन्वर्ट हो रहा है उतनी सेम रेट प्रोडक्ट रिएक्टेंट में भी कन्वर्ट हो रहा है. As a result, the concentration of each species becomes constant and the system is said to be in the dynamic equilibrium. That means it can move in any direction. It can move in forward direction as well as in backward direction depending upon the condition which we are applying. For that, I want to give you an example. Like we can take a live example. Suppose that you two friends are there, okay, and you left the school, left the home for school. You just started, okay, your journey, and there is something like a storm and a big thing like over there. So obviously you will go back because abhi ghar se nikle hi ho. So you have not covered the maximum distance towards the school. So that's why your one and only choice will be there. So to go back home. Okay, second case, like you are supposed to reach to school, okay. Like you, your school, your home is far away from wherever you are right now. That your school is far away from this, and you have just almost about to reach in that in the school, and then there is a storm. So obviously there is one and only option that you will go to school. Got it? Suppose that you are in between. Third case, I am explaining. You are in the middle of that whole journey or whole we can say passes. Suppose that you have to cover 3 kilometers from your home to school, and you have covered 1.5 kilometers. So now 1.5 kilometers is like from your current location, 1.5 kilometers your school is, and 1.5 kilometers your home is also. So if in that condition the storm comes or something is happening over there, so you have choice for both. Like you can go in the forward way, that means to school, as well as to home in the backward direction. So what you will choose? So that completely depends upon the factor, which factor are over. Suppose that your friend will say ki, okay, let's go back to home. Ghar pe chalte hain, enjoy karenge, masti karenge. And you are now convinced with your friend. So what you will do? You will go back. Suppose that your friend is saying ki, no. Let's go to school. Today, very important topics are going to be delivered by the teachers in the school. So, we are supposed to be in the school. And now you are convinced in that way. So, you have to come to school. So, that means in that condition, you have the option to go backward direction as well as forward direction. And where you are moving, that totally depends upon the condition. And the condition is your friend. So, similarly, in this equilibrium also, there will be some condition which will decide whether the reaction is going to move in forward direction or it will move in backward direction. And since it can move in both directions, so that's why we can say that equilibrium is dynamic in nature. I hope it is clear. Okay. So now, dynamic means moving at a microscopic level. The system is in motion. Thus, although there is no apparent change at equilibrium, yet both forward and backward reactions continue to take place, and rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. This is very important thing, and it is we are going to use this again and again in this whole chapter. Okay. Now next is reactant, and here is product. You can see that this animation that two ants are there. One is jitna one ant reactant se leke product mein ja rahi hai, utna hi dusra jo hai wo kya kar rahi hai, product se leke reactant mein. So that means there is no change in the concentration, and this is in the equilibrium. You can see, yes. So this is, there is no change. Jitna wo reactant se leke upar wali first wali, ye this is, this one is ye product ko reactant mein rakh rahi hai, and this one is keeping the reactant molecule from the reacting molecule to the product molecule. So both are having same speed, same potential. So that's why this is no change in reactant concentration as well as in the product concentration. Yes. So that means we can say that this is in equilibrium. Now, again, the chemical equilibrium is again divided into two parts. That is first physical equilibrium. What is that? Physical equilibrium. So the physical equilibrium set up in the physical process. That means that will call physical equilibrium. Physical setup, physical process ka matlab kya hoga? That will be solid to liquid, liquid to gas, gas to liquid, like this. Yes. So we'll do one by one. For example, equilibrium is in the melting of ice to water, evaporation of water to steam, dissolution of sugar in water. So this is melting of equilibrium in melting of ice. That means it is going to be solid to liquid. It will be there. No, that stays. Evaporation of water, that means liquid to gas. And here dissolution of sugar in water, that means solid to liquid state. Okay, so all three equilibrium we will understand, physical equilibrium we will understand one by one. So first is equilibrium for in physical process, and that is equilibrium in three states of matter. We know that substances exist in three states: solid, liquid and gases. And the following three types of equilibrium can exist between these three states. What are that? Solid and liquid will be in the equilibrium. Next, liquid and gas will be in the equilibrium. And third, solid and gas will be in the equilibrium. These three we have to understand. Okay. Now, this process is solid to liquid. We know that it is called melting. Yes, solid to liquid is called melting, while liquid to solid is called freezing. Yes, this is freezing and this one is melting. So, if we talk about the equilibrium, then the rate of melting will be equal to rate of freezing, isn't it? Similarly, liquid to gas, it means it is, this is called vaporization or evaporation. Gas to liquid is condensation. So we can say that rate of condensation is equal to rate of vaporization. Similarly, solid to gas is called sublimation. Yes. And gas to solid is called deposition. So we can say that rate of sublimation is equal to rate of deposition. So let's do this solid liquid equilibrium. First we will do. This state is represented as H2O solid change into H2O liquid. Yes, ice, H2O solid, that means ice, and H2O liquid means water. So they are in the equilibrium stage, ice and water. So we can say that rate of melting equilibrium at the equilibrium point, rate of melting of ice will be equal to rate of freezing of water. Yes, the temperature at which the solid and liquid phase are at equilibrium at atmospheric pressure is called normal freezing point or melting point. And that's why freezing point and melting point for a substance is always same. The only difference is that freezing point will be for the liquid and melting point will be for the solid. So this exists as a at a equilibrium, normal freezing point or melting point. It will, can say melting point will be for the solid and freezing point will be for the liquid. So at equilibrium, rate of melting will be equal to rate of freezing. Thus at equilibrium, both process, melting and freezing, occur simultaneously, and both process occur at same rate, so that the amount of substance on the both side becomes constant. Clear? Equilibrium pe like this it happens. Next is liquid vapor equilibrium. This state is represented as H2O liquid change into H2O gas. That means H2O liquid, you can say that water, and H2O gas, that means steam or vapor. Yes. So water and water vapor, this is at equilibrium. Rate of evaporation, water will convert into vapor by the process of evaporation or vaporization, we can say. So rate of evaporation will be equal to rate of condensation. Got it? The pressure exerted by the vapors in the equilibrium with the liquid at a particular temperature is called equilibrium vapor pressure. Equilibrium pe whatever the pressure is applied by the gaseous molecule or the water vapor on the liquid surface will be called equilibrium vapor pressure, or it is called vapor pressure of the liquid. This is very important point. What do you mean by vapor pressure of liquid? Just you have to know this. Vapor pressure of the liquid is the pressure applied by the vapor molecules on the liquid surface at its equilibrium. Got it? Now the next thing, it may be noted that equilibrium cannot be attained in an open vessel. In this condition, in this particular condition, liquid vapor equilibrium, if that container is in the open vessel, if that that is happening in the open vessel, then the equilibrium may not be attained. Hum attend kar hi nahi sakte because condensation to hoga hi nahi possible. All the water molecules will vaporize, but there is no chance to condense that water vapors into water. Yes. So in the open vessels, equilibrium cannot be attained. This is obvious because an open vessel, the reverse process, that is condensation of vapors back to water, will not take place. Yes. Now note for note, you have to learn some points. The time taken for complete evaporation of the liquid depends upon the nature of liquid, amount of liquid, and temperature. All thus decide what will be the evaporation time, how much time it will be taken. It will be taken by that substance, by that liquid, to evaporate. So, which type of nature liquid is there? What are the amount of liquid and what are the temperature? Example ke liye, if I will keep one glass water and one glass oil, water will evaporate soon, but oil nahi evaporate hoga, isn't it? Amount of liquid, if I am taking one glass water and 10 ml water, obviously 10 ml water will vaporize, will evaporate first. Amount of liquid, temperature, suppose that 10 ml water ko we are boiling at 100 degree and something like it is at the room temperature. So, obviously, 100 degree wala jaldi evaporate ho jayega. Got it? So, it also depends upon the temperature. For a liquid at atmospheric pressure, and atmospheric pressure is 1.013 bar. This is to be learned. Ye aapko learn karna hoga, this value you have to learn. Okay? The temperature at which the liquid and vapor are at equilibrium is called boiling point. So, this definition, boiling point ki definition aage puchi jayegi. So, you have to say that what is boiling point. Boiling point is the temperature at where the vapor pressure of the liquid becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. That is called boiling point. And boiling point depends upon the atmospheric pressure. If there is low atmospheric pressure, obviously the boiling point will be low. If the atmospheric pressure is high, it will be boiling point will be high. And that's the reason ki jo hilly area ya mountains pe hote hain, wahan pe atmospheric pressure bahut kam hota hai. So liquid boils very easily. Bahut jaldi wo boil ho jate hain. Because wo boiling point pe turant achieve kar jate hain. So that's why wahan pe बॉयल तो हो जाएंगे बट कुकिंग इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन दैट. चीजें बॉयल हो जाएंगी बहुत जल्दी बट कुकिंग जो होगा दैट मीन्स चीजों का जो पल्सेस होते हैं या समथिंग जिनको गलना पड़ता है सो दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल एट दैट. तो इट टेक्स लॉन्ग टाइम एंड दैट्स व्हाई वहां पे प्रेशर कुकर इज मस्ट थिंक. ओके चलिए नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट सॉलिड एंड गैस इक्विलिब्रियम. सॉलिड गैस इक्विलिब्रियम एग्जिस्ट इन सिस्टम वेयर सॉलिड सबलाइम टू वेपर. सॉलिड जो होता है वो सब्लाइम हो जाता है. वी नो दैट देयर आर स्पेशल प्रॉपर्टीज फॉर द सॉलिड व्हिच कैन बी सब्लाइम व्हिच कैन डायरेक्टली कन्वर्ट इनटू वेपर. ऑल द सॉलिड मॉलिक्यूल्स कैन नॉट. फ्यू लाइक आयोडीन वी कैन से, नेफ्थलीन वी कैन से, अमोनियम क्लोराइड वी कैन से. सो दीज आर द सब्सटेंस व्हिच कैन सब्लाइम टू वेपर डायरेक्टली. व्हेन वी प्लेस सम सॉलिड आयोडीन इन अ क्लोज्ड वेसल एंड वार्म इट, आयोडीन सब्लाइम टू आयोडीन वेपर्स. द वेसल गेट्स फिल्ड अप with the violet vapor and the intensity of color increases with time. Jitna zyada iodine vaporize hota jayega, the intensity of that violet color will be darker. Yes? So, the state correspond to equilibrium state. It may be represented as I2 solid change into I2 vapor. Some other examples. Ammonium chloride solid change into ammonium chloride vapor. You might have observed this thing in your 9th class experiment. Yes? Camphor solid, camphor vapor, it can be, they can be in the equilibrium. Now, equilibrium involving dissolution. Dissolution, that means dissolving solid molecules in the water. That is called dissolution. Okay, dissolving solid in liquid. So, we can write there, dissolution is dissolving okay. So, now solid in liquids. The state is represented as sugar in solution and sugar solid. So, whenever I must write that sugar solid and then sugar in solution, I should write. But it's okay, no issue. So, that is in equilibrium. That means, sugar ko jab hum water mein add karte hain, toh it forms a sugar water solution. So, that is called sugar solution. So, it will be, this process is called dissolution. So, if we move in this way, like this one backward direction, if we go, this is called dissolution. And if we go forward, if you see forward, so this will be called crystallization. Okay, so we can say that the rate of crystallization is equal to rate of dissolution at equilibrium. Rate of dissolution of sugar will be equal to rate of crystallization of sugar. Okay. at this stage, the number of molecules into going into the solution, that means dissolution process, becomes equal to number of sugar molecule depositing back on the undissolved sugar from the solution, that is called crystalline process. Actually, dissolution is not only the process for dissolving sugar into liquid, but mainly jo word use kiya jata hai, toh that is whenever we talk about dissolving or dissolution, we generally consider that solid in liquid. But it's not like that, it is confined for the solid only. Got it? So here it is said that, that dissolution process, that means solid into liquid, and crystallization process, like when we get the sugar crystal back. Okay. Now, gases in liquid. Let us take an example. When carbon dioxide is dissolved in soda water, the following equilibrium exists: carbon dioxide gas into carbon dioxide in solution. Okay. So, this is also called dissolution. This is also called dissolution, we can say over here. The solubility of gas in liquid depends on the pressure. This is going to be an important point, and we have to do it in this point in very detail in class 12th solution chapter. So here also I will give you some hint over there. So the solubility of gas in the liquid depends on the pressure. This is again, as I said, that this point is very important point. The solubility of gas in the liquid depends upon the pressure. Higher the pressure, higher will be the solubility of gas. Got it? The dependence of the solubility in a gas and its pressure above solvent is given by the law, Henry's law. This is the Henry law, which decides that Henry's law. It will decide that how much gas will be dissolved in this process, pressure. So higher the pressure, higher will be the solubility of gas. It states that mass of gas dissolved in given mass of solvent at a particular temperature is proportional to pressure of the gas above the solvent. Got it? That means jitna bhi gas dissolve hoga in a given mass of solvent at a particular temperature, that will be directly proportional to pressure. Higher the mass, higher will be the solubility. Higher the pressure, higher will be the solubility of gas in the solvent in at a particular temperature. Mathematically represent as M directly proportional to P, and M is here amount of gas dissolved in particular amount of solvent. Or if we remove this proportional sign, we put a constant. So K is the constant, and that is called Henry's constant. Okay. So now, an application of Henry's law. In soda water bottles, the gaseous carbon dioxide exists in equilibrium with the carbon dioxide exists in water. When the soda water bottle is opened, the carbon dioxide dissolves in it and escapes out rapidly with a fizz. This fizzing out of soda bottle can be easily understood by Henry's law. We can easily say that the soda bottle jo bhi hota hai, that is sealed by adding carbon dioxide at very high pressure. So whenever we just open it directly, what happens, the gases, the pressure decreases, and hence the solubility of carbon dioxide in the solution decreases, and that's why carbon dioxide try to escape out from the solution with a fizz. So because of high pressure, there is plenty of gas dissolved in that solution. When the soda bottle is opened, the pressure of the gas inside the bottle is considerably decreased, and hence it comes out as a fizz. Since the solubility of gas is proportional to the pressure, the solubility decreases considerably. As a result, the gas escapes from the solution rapidly with a fizz. However, if the soda bottle is left open to air for some time, it does not fizz anymore, as the pressure inside the bottle and the outside becomes same. If like I will remove the cap and I will keep it like this. So what will happen? Dheere dheere gas jo hai wo pressure down hota jayega, and it will come to the equilibrium. That means the pressure inside the bottle and the pressure outside will remain same, and then there will be no gas coming out from the solution. Okay, so general characteristics of physical equilibrium. What are that general characteristics? Let me explain to you. The general character of equilibrium involving physical process are summed up as the measurable properties of the system becomes constant at equilibrium. That means there will be no change, no concentration change, no color change, no temperature change, no pressure change. It will be constant. Equilibrium can be established only in case of closed system. The system should be neither gain matter nor from surrounding nor lose matter to the surrounding. That means first thing, it should be reversible, and second thing, it should be closed system. Then only the equilibrium can be attained. At equilibrium, both the opposing process occurs at the same rate. That means it moves in the forward direction and in backward direction. That process will be same at the same rate, and that's why it is called dynamic. When equilibrium is attained, there exists an expression of concentration of the substance involved in equilibrium, which becomes constant at a given temperature. That line I will explain you later on. Okay. It says that equilibrium is attained. There exists an expression of concentration. Ye kya hai? That we will do in the next lecture. Okay. So let's do next topic. That is the magnitude of the constant value of concentration related expression called equilibrium constant gives an indication of the extent to which the reaction proceeds before acquiring equilibrium. These two points we will learn in the next video. Okay. So now there is a question for you. There's a homework. So this is as a homework. You are supposed to do whatever you have done till now, whatever you understood, according to that, you just answer this question. In the next video, I will discuss this question first, and then we will move to next topic. So that's it for today. I think you got it, whatever I have explained, you understood this thing. So next we have to do that chemical equilibrium, and lots of numerical will also be there, which is easy. So don't worry about that, which is easy. We will do. And I hope you got it. So we'll meet you in the next video. Till then, thank you, class.